Let me address the people on the West Coast for a second. You know Carl's Jr., the fast food restaurant that's practically everywhere? Well, I'm not sure if you knew this or not, but they don't have Carl's Jr. in the East. The closest thing they have is Hardee's, and as you can tell from the logos, it's pretty close. Look at these logos, they're almost identical, both in the same font, same coloring, white letters with red surrounding them. They both say Char-Broiled Burgers under the name. They both have a proud looking smiling star. These two restaurants are clearly related in some way, and that's true, they are. But they didn't start that way. There's two separate restaurants and two separate stories to tell here. One is about a man named Wilbur Hardee, who started Hardee's. And the other is about Carl Karcher, who started Carl's Jr., two men who named restaurants after themselves. In 1941, Carl Karcher had $15 saved, and he borrowed $325 that he used to buy a hot dog cart in California. In a few short years, he turned that single hot dog cart into, well, four hot dog carts. But in 1945, Carl opened a stationary restaurant, but it wasn't Carl's Jr. It was called Carl's Drive-In Barbecue. In 1956 came the first actual Carl's Jr. restaurant, and the second. He opened two at once. By the 1960s, it was practically the same restaurant that we're familiar with today. It even had their happy little star on the sign. Over the past 50 years, Carl's Jr. has grown into the fast food giant that we have today, expanding all over the West Coast, as I've said already. So there's a pretty good success story, turning a cheap little hot dog cart into one of the biggest fast food chains in the country. And remember, all of this happened in the West. That first hot dog cart ran the streets of California, and the business hasn't expanded far from it. The other story to be told takes place on the East Coast, in North Carolina. This story starts nearly 20 years later, in 1960, and it concerns a man named Wilbur Hardee. By the time Hardee hit the scene, burger places were already huge. He saw their popularity with customers and figured it was a great opportunity to make some money. He opened his own restaurant, modeled it after McDonald's, and he called it Hardee's Drive-In. Now, soon after that, Wilbur Hardee partnered with two guys, but then quickly left the partnership, leaving the restaurant with those other two guys. So strangely enough, Hardee is the man who started it all, but he left it when it was still only a single location. After that, Hardee's grew pretty quick, 200 locations in their first 10 years and 1,000 locations within their first 15. It has gone through some changes in ownership over the years, but has still managed to grow into the massive fast food giant that we all know today. But remember again, all of this happened in the East. The company started in North Carolina and hasn't ventured all that far from it. Not quite the same success story for Wilbur Hardee, but a very similar story for the restaurants. But I left out one major part of both stories. As of 1997, the two have been the same company. Let's look at this from the view of Carl's Jr. They're a huge fast food restaurant, but hadn't yet broke into any markets outside of their little safety zone in the West. And it's hard. You have to think about the suppliers and the real estate and all the other stuff that keeps a business up and running, as well as the customers. Few people in the East even knew what Carl's Jr. was, especially in 1997. No brand recognition, no reputation. Most everything they had going for them was only good in the West. So expanding into the East would feel a lot like starting over, but there was an easier way to do it, an acquisition. Just think of it like this. Pretend I'm a rich guy that wants to own a successful shoe company. I get all my resources together and I try to start one. But then consider all the money and the time it takes to find all the suppliers and the labor and just making the public aware of it. And plus the years it could take for my shoe brand to earn any respect. Starting my own company is the hard way to do it. Since, well, I'm rich, I'll look into doing it the easy way. I'll go out and I'll see if it would be possible for me to buy a shoe company that already already exists. If I just purchase Nike or Reebok, all that stuff is already done for me, and now I own a successful shoe company. Just think of Carl's Jr. as a rich guy who wanted to own a chain of successful East Coast fast food restaurants. Instead of opening their own, it's easier just to buy one that already exists. And when searching for which one to buy, Hardee's was exactly what they were looking for. Hardee's just happened to be only on the East Coast, exactly what they wanted. It was then owned by a Canadian tobacco company that wasn't doing all that well with it. So Carl's Jr. offered them $327 million to take it off their hands, and they agreed. This was a huge acquisition. Just based on the number of locations, Hardee's was much bigger than Carl's Jr. 3,152 Hardee's restaurants compared to only 676 for Carl's Jr. Meaning, with a single acquisition, they now had 5 times more locations, and they became the 4th largest fast food chain in the United States, behind only McDonald's, Burger King, and Wendy's. In what looks like an attempt to make the public aware of their association, Carl's Jr. decided to develop a Hardee's logo that looks nearly identical to theirs. Now, that explains the similar logos, but the question we've yet to answer is, are these two the same? Is there a difference between Carl's Jr. and Hardee's? And from what I can tell, there's not much difference at all. Aside from Carl's Jr. just using Hardee's to expand, they use them to improve their menu. Hardee's has always been known for their breakfast and their biscuits. Well, the acquisition meant that Carl's Jr. could now sell these same biscuits and other breakfast items in their restaurants. And conversely, Hardee's would theoretically be able to benefit from selling items from the Carl's Jr. menu. From what I can tell, they've tried to combine the best of both worlds to create a hybrid menu that's nearly identical in both restaurants. Here's the Carl's Jr. menu on their website. Breakfast, burgers, chicken, all-star meals, here's the double cheeseburger and onion rings. And here's the Hardee's menu, obviously going for the same design, and the items are just about the same as well. Breakfast, burgers, chicken, and there's the double cheeseburger and onion rings all-star meal. Really, there's only 2 big differences that I can point out. One is salads. It looks like Carl's Jr. sells salads where Hardee's doesn't. Or if they do, they don't emphasize them in the same way. But it makes sense to me, the California crowd is generally more health conscious than the Southerners. Basically, just regional differences. If you were to compare the menus for McDonald's or Burger King in different regions, I'm sure you'll find little differences like this. The other difference is this green burrito section. Green Burrito is another fast food restaurant bought by Carl's Jr. They kind of combine the locations, like 2 different restaurants in the same building. Walk in there and you can order from the Carl's Jr. menu or the Green Burrito menu. But you're going to love this part. I go back to the Hardee's menu and that section is labeled Red Burrito. They started that name themselves. So now in the East, you can go to a Hardee's / Red Burrito, and it's essentially the same thing as going to a Carl's Jr. / Green Burrito in the West. They've created quite a mess with their brands. Ideally, I think they would want everything to be named the same. Instead of having brand recognition through half the country, twice, they'd prefer just to be known all throughout the country. Plus, consider things like running commercials and printing labels on cups. It's just easier if it's all one brand. They've tried to transform some Hardee's locations into Carl's Jr.'s, but as you might expect, it didn't go over too well. People in the East like Hardee's. Not Carl's Jr. Not much they can do about that. They could potentially label all restaurants with both names or do a Hardee's is now Carl's Jr. type campaign, but those both have their own disadvantages as well. They've made their compromise by keeping the separate names, but making just about everything else identical. let me know in the comments your thoughts on these two restaurants. They have a very unique way of branding themselves, so do you think this is the best possible way to do it? Sort of seems like there's no perfect answer. And if you live in one of the two states that have both restaurants, or if you're a traveler that's familiar with both, have you experienced much of a difference between them? Personally, I've never been to either, but from what I can see, they appear to be the same. Also, if you're someone who's been to either before 1997, I'd be interested to hear exactly how they've changed since joining forces. I'd like to hear what you have to say. And quickly, you want to know why it's called Carl's Jr. and not just Carl's or something like that? Remember I said the guy first started a restaurant called Carl's Drive-In Barbecue? Well, when he started his new chain, Carl's Jr., the locations were smaller than the first restaurant. Putting Jr. in the name was just a way to convey that. This video somehow felt incomplete without mentioning that. Alright, now it's complete. Thank you for watching.